I should restart that. Signal for the editor. Wait for the noise to stop. I said it like an idiot. Jesus Christ. Is there anything else I should add? Hi there, I'm David, and today we're going to talk about the Asimov Cascade Failure and Mortyplicity, Season 5, Episode 2 of Rick and Morty. Let's get started. First of all, who is Isaac Asimov? Isaac Asimov was a biochemistry professor and also a prolific science fiction author. He is who created the three laws of robotics. And let's go through those right now. So the first law of robotics is that a robot may not harm a human being or through inaction allow a human being come to harm. Number two is a robot must obey the orders given to it by human beings, except where such orders would conflict with the first law. And the third law is a robot must protect its own existence as long as such protection does not conflict with the first or second law. So the Asimov Cascade Failure in Rick and Morty was more of a comedic nod to famed author. There isn't really such a thing as an Asimov Cascade Failure, but there is such a thing as a Cascade Failure. So what is that? Basically, a Cascade Failure is the result of a networked or grouped systems having one failure leading to other failures. I've created a little map here to help picture this. All right, so let's go through this really quick. Imagine that there is a failure in one system, and that one failure causes another system to fail. Well, all of a sudden its neighbors start to fail and it cascades all the way through the system where the entire thing has ended up failing. Cascade failure. It's also applicable in various studies of physics and other sciences as well. So that's a cascade failure. Basically, just a failure that cascades from one root cause and completely takes over and shuts down the entire system, whatever that system may be. So in Rick and Morty, episode 2, Mortyplicity, there was a code used to shut down or to freeze the clones. Now, these codes might seem a little familiar. 80085 is a nod to The Simpsons, which, if you were to put it in a calculator, spells boobs. And the other one, 8 == D. Of course, you could probably figure that one out on your own. I'm not going to elaborate on that. So the entire idea behind the Decoy Cascade Failure, or as they called it, Asimov Cascade Failure, was that when a Rick created decoys, that Rick created decoys, and there might have been more than one, so every single decoy had created decoys as well, and you can see that this ends up becoming a very complicated web intertwined with itself. And if we look over here at our network of systems that can fail in a cascade, well, we can apply the very same thing here, something like a hierarchical tree. So the decoys made decoys, and eventually at the end of the episode, we end up finding the wooden puppets, which were a natural, or maybe unnatural, degradation from the original Rick, who created the initial decoys. So the decoys created decoys, and the decoys created decoys, and the decoys started to find out that they were decoys, and became the squid monsters that we ended up seeing taking out the other versions of Rick and his family. So these squid monster people were very adept at killing other Smith families. And later on in the episode, spoiler warning, we end up finding out that they are Smith families themselves. So of course, Rick would devise ways to kill himself if there was another Rick just as smart or as dangerous as he is. And another thing to note about Isaac Asimov is that he was the author of a collection of short stories called I, Robot, or I, Robot. If you ever get a chance, check it out. So, don't forget to subscribe, check out other videos, like, share, comment, ring that bell for notifications for future videos, and we'll see you next time.